This video is sponsored by RKDF University, Radisson Blue. Good morning, I'm Dusha Agarwal and you're watching News Flash. Today is the 22nd of May and we have a lineup of crucial stories touching every corner of the globe. From the latest developments in politics to groundbreaking advancements in technology. The Sindh government announced plans to conduct random drug tests in all private and government schools due to rising cases of student drug use, particularly crystal meth. Information Minister Sharjeel Memon cited the recent arrest of a high-profile drug supplier in Clifton as a catalyst for the new initiative. A Greek court dismissed charges against 9 Egyptian men accused of causing a shipwreck that killed hundreds of migrants off Greece last year, citing lack of jurisdiction as the disaster occurred in international waters. The Adriana fishing trawler carrying up to 700 migrants from Pakistan, Syria and Egypt sank off the coast of Pylos on June 14 after departing from Libya, bound for Italy. A Singapore Airlines flight from London to Singapore experienced extreme turbulence on Monday, resulting in the death of one passenger and injuring several dozen others. The Boeing 777-300ER with 211 passengers and 18 crew members on board made an emergency landing in Bangkok due to the severe weather conditions. In the wake of a human trafficking racket being busted here recently, Andhra Pradesh police on Tuesday said around 300 Indians revolted against their handlers in Cambodia on May 20, leading to most of them being arrested in the foreign country. US sanctions had worsened aviation safety, Russian Foreign Minister Sergey Lavrov said on Tuesday, a day after Iranian President Ibrahim Raisi, Foreign Minister Hossein Amir Abdullahian, along with others killed in a helicopter crash. Vietnamese authorities have urged Apple supplier Foxconn to voluntarily slash power usage by at least 30% at its assembly plants in the northern region, following electricity outages experienced last year. US Secretary of State Antony Blinken is due to make his case for President Joe Biden's $64 billion foreign affairs budget request in 4 congressional hearings this week amid deep divides with Republicans over spending priorities and Israel policy. Former Iranian Foreign Minister Javed Zarif has blamed the United States for the helicopter crash that killed Iran's President Ibrahim Raisi and Foreign Minister Hossein Amir Abdullahian. The crash occurred in Iran's mountains north amid bad weather. An elderly Russian physicist named Anatoly Maslov has found guilty of treason on Tuesday and sentenced to 14 years in a correctional colony. Now, this is just one of those trials against scientists who have worked on the science underlying Russia's development of hypersonic weapons. Microsoft Corp CEO Satya Nadella is focusing on a new era of computing driven by specialized artificial intelligence chips and improved performance. This strategy aims to rejuvenate the long-standing rivalry between Windows PCs and Apple Inc.'s Mac. Finland's government has introduced emergency legislation to block asylum seekers from entering across its borders with Russia, citing concerns about Moscow's perceived encouragement of such crossings amid political tensions following the Ukraine war. It is time for a break now. We'll be back with more news. Stay tuned.
खानदानी लुटेरों की कोशिश होगी बेकार, फिर एक बार मोदी सरकार.
शिक्षा देश का गौरव है और RKDF यूनिवर्सिटी शिक्षा का उद्रम है. RKDF में सवारे अपना भविष्य. PhD, MPhil करे अपने पसंदीदा विषय में. सर्टिफिकेट डिप्लोमा के 74 कोर्सेज. RKDF यूनिवर्सिटी.
2 statues smuggled out of Thailand, including a 900-year-old sculpture that spent 3 decades at the Metropolitan Museum of Art in New York, were welcomed back to the kingdom in an official repatriation ceremony in Bangkok on Tuesday. North Korean leader Kim Jong-un offered to give up his न्यूक्लियर आर्सेनल इफ अमेरिका गारंटीड हिज रिजीम वुड सर्वाइव, फॉर्मर साउथ कोरियन प्रेसिडेंट मून जेइन सेड इन अ रीसेंट रिलीज ऑन मेमोयर. द इरान बैक्ड हूथी रिबेल्स इन येमेन क्लेम्ड ऑन ट्यूसडे दे शॉट डाउन एन अमेरिकन ड्रोन ओवर द इम्पॉवरिश्ड अरब कंट्री. नाउ द यूएस मिलिट्री डिड नॉट इमीडिएटली एक्नॉलेज द क्लेम. If confirmed, this would be the second MQ-9 Reaper drone downed by the Houthis over the past week as they press their campaign over the Israel-Hamas war in the Gaza Strip. India's digital economy is on a significant growth trajectory, expanding at a rate of 2.8% annually. The Minister of State for Electronics and IT, Rajiv Chandrasekhar, shared this projection during an outreach program highlighting the country's potential to reach a USD 1 trillion digital economy by 2027-28. Boeing's highly anticipated first Starliner astronaut mission featuring Indian origin astronaut Sunita Williams has encountered a setback. Now, the crewed flight test, originally scheduled as Boeing's inaugural space flight, has been postponed to May 25th. The delay follows the discovery of a minor helium leak in the spacecraft's service module. Vice President Jagdeep Dhankar is scheduled to visit the Islamic Republic of Iran on May 22, 2024 to attend the official ceremony offering condolences for the tragic passing of Iranian President Ibrahim Raisi, Foreign Minister Dr. Hossein Amir Abdullahian and other officials in a helicopter crash. An Indigo flight from Mumbai to Varanasi was forced to return to the airport on Tuesday just as it was about to take off after the crew spotted an overbooked passenger standing at the rear of the aircraft. One person was killed and three others injured in post-poll violence in Bihar's Sarwan district on Tuesday morning. Now, the incident occurred in the Bara Thelma area near Bhikari Thakur Chowk, where an altercation between two groups, reportedly supporters of the BJP and RJD, erupted over allegations of irregularities during polling that took place on Monday. Claiming that the NDA has already bagged 310 seats after the completion of five phases of the Lok Sabha polls, Union Home Minister Amit Shah on Tuesday urged the people of Odisha to free the state from Babu Raj and allow the BJP to form government at the centre and also in the state. Prime Minister Narendra Modi launched a scathing attack on the Congress on Tuesday, alleging that its top leaders, including First PM Jawaharlal Nehru, had opposed reservations for deprived castes. Now, Modi made the claim during a rally in Purbi Champaran Lok Sabha constituency in Bihar, stating that without the intervention of Baba Saheb Ambedkar, Nehru would not have agreed to quotas for SCs, STs and OBCs. Defence Minister Rajnath Singh launched a verbal assault on Rahul Gandhi during an election rally in Jharkhand's Bokaro on Tuesday. Now, Singh questioned whether a leader who has been praised by the enemy should be allowed to form the government, citing former Pakistan Minister Fawad Hussain Chaudhry's laudatory remarks about the Congress leader. In Pune's Kalyani Nagar, a tragic incident unfolded as a 17-year-old boy, reportedly intoxicated, struck and killed two motorbike riders in the early hours on Sunday. The victims, a 24-year-old man and woman from Madhya Pradesh, were residents of Pune and working as tech professionals. Following the incident, police arrested the boy's father, realtor Vishal Agarwal, in Aurangabad after charges were filed against him on Monday. That's all for the headlines of the day. For more updates, download the app and keep watching Rhythm.